brought to you by Kellogg's. The folks who bring the best to you each morning. A wide choice of cereals in the forms you like best. Yours from Kellogg's of Battle Creek. Now let's all play What's My Line?
And now let's meet our award-winning panel of What's My Line? First, the popular columnist whose voice of Broadway appears in papers coast to coast, Miss Dorothy Kilgallen.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. And now we're very happy to welcome back to the panel a charming young man who's the star of the television show Who Do You Trust? Mr. Johnny Carson.
And on my left, the feminine part of the team that was just selected by the National Father's Day Foundation as the husband and wife team of the year. Martin couldn't be here. They just had a fight. But here is Arlene Francis.
All right. And now the darling of the publishing world and of our world, Mr. Bennett Cerf.
And here's our distinguished panel moderator, whose constantly receding hairline reveals an ever-expanding mass of unadulterated brain, John Charles Davis.
Now, you've got to admit that puts me in a pretty pickle, doesn't it? Said I got brains, but I'm losing my hair. Now, what do I take objection to? Stuck. Panel, good evening. Johnny Carson, it's very nice to have you with us again, sir.
Thanks, John.
And we're up to our usual tricks. We have some very interesting occupations, some very nice people who brought them to the theater, and we intend to give you as much trouble with both as we possibly can. We'll also have a famous mystery guest before the panel a little bit later in the program, and we'll meet our first challenger after this word. And now let's meet our first contestant. Will you enter and sign in, please? Pamela Proctor, right?
Yes.
Panel, I will announce that it is Miss Pamela Proctor, and with your permission, I will also announce that Miss Pamela is still studying as a student, but that in all of her free hours away from her study, she has a very interesting occupation, which is what you're here to guest tonight. May I ask where you're from?
Hagerstown, Maryland.
Hagerstown, Maryland.
Yes.
That's not too far out of Washington, is
no.
it? Ah, fine. May I present the panel? Now, would you join me over here, please, Miss Proctor? You know how we keep score?
Yes.
Fine, then we'll let the audience here in the theater with us and the audience looking at home know exactly what your line is. Panel, we will tell you that Miss Proxa is salaried, deals in a service, and we'll begin the general questioning with Johnny Carson.
Miss Proxa, is that right?
Proxa.
Yes. Is your service available to both men and women, I hope?
Yes, it is.
Could I avail myself of it? And if I can't, could you tell me how I could? would I be able to?
Yes.
Do you stay in one location when you give your services? I mean, like an office, or do you move around?
Yes.
You do move around, or you stay in the office? Excuse me, I was giving you two questions there. You stay in one place?
Actually, you
yes.
got a yes there, and I'd stick with the yes if I were you, Johnny.
Do you wear any particular garb other than normally what you're wearing tonight?
Yes.
You do? Would this be considered a uniform of some kind?
No.
What was the question? I missed it.
A uniform. Would it be some kind of a uniform?
Well, now, let me have a small conversation.
Oh, I knew this was coming.
Sure.
did you understand her say she moved around?
Johnny, I think we have to give you a no. That actually, in ordinary street clothes, such as Miss Proxy is wearing now, could not be worn, but it is not a uniform which would identify in any degree the occupation. Miss Francis?
If one were to avail oneself of your services, Miss Proxa,
Would you come to the house to be able to take care of those services?
No.
That's $2.08 to go, Mr. Sir.
Miss Proctor, before we go into this, you are studying. May I ask where you are doing your studies?
At North Hagerstown High School.
High school?
Yes.
That's even young for Mr. Daly. Miss Proctor,
I should like to point out that it was not Mr. Daly who was asking the leading questions. Mr. Sir.
Miss Proctor, this uniform, which is not really a uniform that you wear, is that worn for some protective purpose or to keep you clean or to keep you from getting messed up?
No.
No. It's $3.07
it's
to go,
Miss Kugel. It's still not recognizable.
No, actually, it's a matter of convenience, but it has no purpose to protect her against damage or harm of any kind, nor necessarily any purpose to maintain a state of cleanliness of which I'm sure you would approve in any and all circumstances. It's just it's good garb for what has to be done.
Thank you, John.
That's perfectly all right. You know, no hair, but lots of brains. That's Bennett, sir, all the time. Miss Kilgallen.
Well, I've got to stick with this uniform or costume a little bit more. Do you wear anything in the nature of slacks or pants of any kind?
Yes.
Oh. I also would like to straighten out Johnny's question, that double question. I didn't understand whether she said yes to moving around a lot or staying in one place.
Well, I think that we could best clarify this issue by saying that while you perform your service in one location, it could also be said that there is some degree of movement involved in the normal offering of the service.
Is your work physical as well as mental?
Yes.
Would you say it was more physical than mental?
Yes.
Are there men doing what you do?
Yes.
Do you ever get up on a ladder?
No.
That's $4.06 to go, Mr. Carson.
Do you talk at all to the people?
Yes.
You do. Do you lay your hands upon them?
Sometimes.
Was you going to say something, John? Or,
well, actually, I was actually, Johnny, I was pondering whether I should add a word so that you weren't misled. The laying on of hands could be necessary as a part of demonstration, you know. In other words, it would have as its purpose to helpfully instruct.
I see. Do the people who come to you wear anything other than what they would normally wear?
I mean, a business suit, if it was a
yes,
man?
Yes, would they wear some slacks or change their clothes?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Is this a beneficial service? Do the people go away feeling a little better after they've seen you? I know I would.
This is the kind of question you always answer. Say, we hope so.
Yeah.
It just has to do with health.
Sometimes, yes.
It has aspects which certainly could be related to the issue of health.
Do you need any type of training? Has that been established
No.
do what you do? You do need some type of training. Do you need any type of degree at all? You have to get licensed by the state?
That's $5.05 to go, Miss Francis. I'm going to give you one more minute.
Is there something sporting in what you do?
Yes.
Would it be in the family of not physical education, but a kind of thing like jujitsu or judo or anything like that that would require calisthenics?
Yes.
Well, you're kind.
Arlene didn't mention any specific area which I think we can fundamentally relate. Huh?
No.
There we are. That's a good girl. $6.04 to go, Mr. Sir.
Well, now, is there any game involved in what you're teaching? Besides,
no. That's $7.03 to go, Miss Kilgallen.
But there is something in the realm of gymnastics or athletics of some sort.
Yes.
Is it something other than karate?
Yes.
Other than judo and
yes.
other than jujitsu?
Yes.
Is it simple gymnastics? Do you teach reducing or gymnastic tricks?
No.
Not
or
as, no.
Tumbling?
Not, well, it's not gymnastics. We can't accept that description.
Acrobatics?
I flip all the cards because Bennett gave it away and it wasn't his turn to ask a question and therefore it doesn't count. But actually, Bennett has got it right. Ms. Proxon is a trampoline instructor. Bert?
I didn't mean to jump the gun. I thought you said time was up. You said a minute more.
Bennett, I was just kidding. Actually, it was
good.
Dorothy opened the door, and it just progressively you got to what it was. You work at a place called Bounceland. Isn't that a wonderful name? Bounceland in Hagerstown. And one thing that the question didn't elicit that I think will be interesting to all of you at home, about 95% of your clientele are youngsters, aren't they?
Yes.
She teaches youngsters how to use the trampoline, and it's great exercise. I used to do a lot of it myself. Thank you very much. We hope you enjoyed
Thank
your visit
you.
To What's My Line. It was nice to have you here. Happy thought for a spring evening. I'd love to get Bennett on a trampoline. No, I really wouldn't. Let's meet our next contestant. Will you enter and sign in, please?
Well, it's our turn.
Jim? Cook. Right, sir? Jim, where are you from?
Dallas.
Dallas, Texas.
Yes.
Ah, it was nice to have you with us. May I present our panel? Cook from Texas.
Dallas.
Now, will you join me over here, please, sir? You know how we keep score, Jim?
Yes.
All right, if you know how we keep score, we'll let the audience at home and the audience in the theater know exactly what your line is. All right. Panel, Mr. Cook. Mr. Cook is salaried. He deals in a service, and we'll begin the general questioning with, Dorothy Kilgallen.
Mr. Cook, are you an executive?
No.
One down and nine to go, Mr. Carson.
Well, Mr. Cook's a pretty good-looking, rugged guy, which I suppose has nothing to do with what he really does. It is a service?
Mm-hmm.
A service available to both men and women?
Yes.
Is one sex more predominantly the people you deal with?
No.
No, I don't think so. To the degree here that the service is utilized by general population, we would have to agree that one sex does not necessarily benefit more than another. That's two down and eight to go, Miss Francis.
I don't care what you say, John. Women would benefit more.
Boy, there's a lot of spring in this panel tonight, isn't there?
Do you use your hands in your work, Mr. Cook?
Partly.
Mm-hmm.
Do you work out of doors?
Yes.
In a manner of speaking, yes.
Manner of speaking.
Wait a minute, because let me have a small.
No, it's
Yeah, we have to say in a manner of speaking because I think the question is asked in terms of beyond the confines of a normal building. We would have to say yes.
Mm-hmm. Do you have anything to do with animals in any way?
No.
Three down and seven to go, Mr. Cerf.
Mr. Cook, we haven't established whether or not you work for a profit-making organization. I'd like to guess that you work for a non-profit-making organization. Is that correct?
That's correct.
In the course of your work, do you ever have occasion to wear a uniform?
Small thing.
Especially.
Well, here, actually, Jim has answered the question. It's a special rig, but not necessarily uniform. I would like to explain that we use the term uniform very broadly, so that with your permission, we'll give Bennett a yes. It is a special rig, Bennett, but not confined specifically to identify.
May I eliminate, therefore, any kind of military uniform?
Yes.
Would this work bring you ever in contact with oil wells or anything to do with oil?
No.
Four down and six to go, Miss Kilgallen.
Do you ever get off the ground?
Yes.
Are you some type of pilot?
Some type.
Do you qualify as a test pilot?
No.
No. Five down and five to go, Mr. Carson.
A type of pilot.
But not in the military.
But not of the military.
Right. Mm-hmm. Actually, we identified the fact of Mr. Cook's being a pilot. Now, what you really have to do is to find out in what particular service he does fly.
Would this be for the some form of the federal government?
Yes.
Does it have to do with anything lighter than air aircraft?
No.
Six down and four to go, Miss Francis.
You didn't just make a trip in 3 hours or 2 hours and something to Paris, sir.
No.
You're not part of that outfit.
Seven down and three to go, Mr. Sir.
Have you got anything to do with conservation or improving farmlands or flying in the air to look at flood control or weather or something of that department?
Pretty broad.
I think the question is so broad, you know, we'd have to agree that we've got to say yes. It covers so much ground.
He flies into the eye of a cyclone.
Well, I want to ask, has weather got something? Have you do something about the weather?
This is a...
I'm sorry.
Yes.
Do you ever seed clouds or do something about causing rain or preventing it?
No.
Eight down and two to go, but this is remarkable. You're to be congratulated, panel. Miss Kilgallen.
Do you report on or predict weather for other craft?
Occasionally.
There's some name for that?
Well, I tell you what, I'm going to turn all the cards.
Yeah. Is there something, are there people that fly into the eye of a cyclone?
Well, this is why I'm going to throw the card, because you have it, and I think you ought to get full credit for getting it. It's a remarkable job. What Mr. Cook does actually is to track tornadoes by airplane. He is with the Weather Bureau in the Department of Commerce, and he works in that whole southwest area that is tornado country. I think you could best describe it, that you're up, and if you find them, you report the track that the storm is taking so that communities get as much a warning of what's about to happen.
That's part of it, John. It's weather research, severe storm research, actually. Tornadoes and squall lines.
Mr. Cook, what's the difference between a tornado and a hurricane?
The size. The tornado is probably a few hundred feet across, and a hurricane can be several hundred miles.
And when you haven't got one of those going for you, what do you do?
Well, it just goes on all the time, honey. Actually, the specific outfit with which you work is what? Severe?
The CELS, Severe Local Storm Forecast Center in Kansas City.
Severe Local Storm Forecast Center in Kansas. It's called CELS, and it's research and reporting on storms that are in being and the track that they're taking and so forth. Well, we hope you enjoyed being with us down here on good, solid terra firma. Nice to have you with us. Will you take a nice time? We'll meet tonight's mystery guest in just a moment, but first, here is a word from our sponsor. Now we come to the special feature of our program, the appearance of our mystery celebrity, for which the panel is always blindfolded. The blindfold's in place, panel?
Yes, John. Yes,
good. Will you enter Mystery Challenger and sign in, please? Panel, as you know, in this case, you go to a different form of questioning, one question at a time, in turn, moving clockwise. We begin with Bennett Cerf.
Well, judging by your reception, you're one of those hurricanes that the gentleman chases. Are you a beautiful lady?
I will answer that with a resounding yes. Ms. Kilgallen?
Are you currently appearing in person in New York?
Are you appearing in person in New York? You mean in the legitimate theater or supper
or
club?
Supper club or
nightclub. Presentation
night
house or anything like that?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
No.
That's one down and nine to go, Mr. Carson.
Are you busy tonight?
Yes.
Yes. I'll try another tack then.
Going out with that tack.
Are you currently appearing in a motion picture that is in the New York area?
Yes.
Ms. Francis?
Well, if you're here for a motion picture, there has been a great deal of publicity about a very beautiful lady from across the seas that is here to make appearances for what I understand is an award-winning picture called Two Women. Do you have anything to do with that particular picture?
Yes.
Right. Well, my deepest congratulations to a beautiful actress, Sophia Loren.
Right.
I wish I had
seen that. You must have... You mustn't be discouraged, because unfortunately my colleagues over there are brilliant at this game of What's My Line.
Incredible. I was trying to put on some accent, but I didn't succeed in that.
Miss Lorraine, you are so popular that everybody in New York knew you were in New York, and we felt that if we were lucky, we'd have you on this show, that's all.
Thank you.
I think it should go in the record that Arlene has mentioned the film, which is at a New York theater, the Sutton Theater, Two Women, for which Miss Lorraine won the Gold Palm Award as the best actress at the Cannes Film Festival, an honor that I'm quite sure pleased you mightily, but one that also was very properly given to you.
Oh, thank you very much.
Well, I'm
MGM
sorry we didn't...
MGM, isn't it, Miss Lorraine?
I beg your pardon?
MGM?
No, Joe Levine is releasing it here in America, in New York, but in England, Metro-Goldwyn-Mayer has the picture.
Mm-hmm. Yes, Dorothy?
John, I've seen it, and I can testify that it's a marvelous performance, the best of her career and the best of any actress this year that I've seen.
Thank you.
Wonderful. And thank you very much, ma'am, for spending some time with us. We'll have another contestant after this word from our alternate sponsor. And now let's meet a final contestant. Will you enter and sign in, please? Andy? Parrish, right?
Right.
Where are you from?
Cedar Grove, New Jersey.
Cedar Grove, New Jersey. May I present the panel? Ready? Will you join me over here? You know how we keep score, Andy?
Yes, sir.
All right, then fine. We'll let the audience here and the audience at home know what your line is. All right. Panel, we don't have too much time, so I will tell you very quickly that Mr. Peretti is salaried, that he deals in a product, and we'll begin the general questioning with Arlene Francis.
Ready, is it a product that I might use?
Yes, ma'am.
Would I enjoy using it?
Definitely.
Would the rest of us on the panel also use it?
Yes, ma'am.
Would I use it indoors?
Yes, ma'am.
Would I use it in any particular room of the house?
Usually.
Would that room be the kitchen?
Possibly.
Would I just as soon use it in another room, perhaps? The bedroom, could it be used in?
Not particularly.
Not particularly, but under some circumstances, it might be what we were trying
to... It's a get-around product.
It's a get-around product, yes.
Could I hold it in my hand?
No.
No.
Wait a minute now, because here we get a little bit involved. The product, in terms of your potential use of it, would have now a character which, in some instances, would make it possible to hold it in the hand. So you proceed.
Would I apply it to anything?
No.
No. You mean rub it in? It'd be pretty silly. One down, nine to go, Mr. Sir.
Mr. Peretti, has the product that you deal with at any time been alive?
Yes.
Is it either animal or bird?
Yes.
He's not going to have any trouble with you.
All right, bird.
No.
No.
Is it animal?
Yes.
Has it been a domestic animal?
No.
Three down and seven to go, Mr. Cuff.
This is some type of wild animal that once was alive.
Yes.
And ran into trouble. Would you use this, say, in the living room of the house?
No.
No, I think we would have to give you a flat no on that. This does not rule out the possibility under very special circumstances it might be used,
sure,
but you wouldn't normally expect to.
Yeah.
Miss Francis.
But it is not an animal that we eat, evidently.
Yes.
That makes it five down
to
five.
Oh, it is an animal we eat. Oh, you don't rub it in, you swallow it.
We just ran out of time, and that's a wonderful note to run out of time on. Actually, Mr. Peretti buys turtles, you know, the big turtles, which are then rendered into turtle soup and turtle stew and turtles. You know, turtles. So, well, there we are. It's actually the Bon Vivant Soup Company. Bon Vivant Soup Company. So most of it goes into that wonderful turtle soup. Thank you very much, sir,
for
being our guest. It was nice to have you with us.
Now,
very quickly, because we're short of time, if you'd like to apply to puzzle the panel with your occupation, send a snapshot, one that you can spare. Name, occupation, and send this information to What's My Line, CBS 485 Madison Avenue, New York 22, New York. And now we're short of time for the panel and for me. Thank you very much for being with us on What's My Line.
What's My Line is a CBS Television Network production in association with Mark Goodson and Bill Cotman.
...than what they would normally wear.
You mean a business suit, if it was a
yes,
man?
Yes, but they wear some slacks or change their clothes.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Is this a beneficial service? Do the people go away feeling a little better after they've seen you? I know I would.
This is the kind of question you always answer. Say, we hope so.
Yeah.
It just has to do with health.
Sometimes, yes.
It has aspects which certainly could be related to the issue of health.
Do you need any type of training? Has that been established
No.
do what you do? You do need
yes.
some type of training. Do you need any type of degree at all? You have to get
no.
licensed by the state?
That's five down and five to go, Miss Francis. I'm going to give you one more minute.
Is there something sporting in what you do?
Yes.
Would it be in the family of not physical education, but a kind of thing like jujitsu or judo or anything like that that would require calisthenics?
Yes.
Calisthenics. You're kind.
Arlene didn't mention any specific area which I think we can fundamentally relate. Huh?
No.
There we are. That's a good girl. Six down and four to go, Mr. Sayers.
Well, now, is there any game involved in what you're teaching? Besides,
no. That's seven down and three to go, Miss Kilgallen.
But there is something in the realm of gymnastics or athletics of some sort.
Yes.
Is it something other than karate?
Yes.
Other than judo and
yes.
other than jujitsu?
Yes.
Is it simple gymnastics? Do you teach reducing or gymnastic tricks?
No.
Not
or
as, no.
Tumbling?
Not, well, it's not gymnastics. We can't accept that description.
Jumping up and down on one of those trampolines?
I flip all the cards because Bennett gave it away and it wasn't his turn to ask a question and therefore it doesn't count. Now, you've got to admit that puts me in a pretty pickle, doesn't it? Said I got brains, but I'm losing my hair. Now, what do I take objection to? Stuck. Panel, good evening. Johnny Carson,
good evening.
It's very nice to have you with us again, sir.
Thanks, John.
And we're up to our usual tricks. We have some very interesting occupations, some very nice people who brought them to the theater, and we intend to give you as much trouble with both as we possibly can. Mm-hmm. We'll also have a famous mystery guest before the panel a little bit later in the program, and we'll meet our first challenger after this word. And now let's meet our first contestant. Will you enter and sign in, please? Pamela? Proxa, right?
Yes.
Panel, I will announce that it is Miss Pamela Proxer, and with your permission, I will also announce that Miss Pamela is still studying as a student, but that in all of her free hours away from her study, she has a very interesting occupation, which is what you're here to guess tonight. May I ask where you're from?
Hagerstown, Maryland.
Hagerstown, Maryland.
Yes.
That's not too far out of Washington, is
no.
it? Ah, fine. May I present the panel? Now, would you join me over here, please, Miss Proxer? You know how we keep score?
Yes.
Fine, then we'll let the audience here in the theater with us and the audience looking at home know exactly what your line is. All right. Panel, we will tell you that Miss Proxer is salaried, deals in a service, and we'll begin the general questioning with Johnny Carson.
Miss Proxer, is that right?
Proxer.
Yes.
Is your service available to both men and women, I hope?
Yes, it is.
Could I?
What's My Line? Brought to you by Kellogg's, the folks who bring the best to you each morning. A wide choice of cereals in the forms you like best. Yours from Kellogg's of Battle Creek. Now let's all play What's My Line?
And now let's meet our award-winning panel of What's My Line? First, the popular columnist whose voice of Broadway appears in papers coast to coast, Miss Dorothy Kilgallen.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. And now we're very happy to welcome back to the panel a charming young man who's the star of the television show Who Do You Trust? Mr. Johnny Carson.
And on my left, the feminine part of the team that was just selected by the National Father's Day Foundation as the husband and wife team of the year. Martin couldn't be here. They just had a fight. But here is Arlene Francis.
That's right. And now the darling of the publishing world and of our world, Mr. Bennett Cerf.
And here's our distinguished panel moderator, whose constantly receding hairline reveals an ever-expanding mass of unadulterated brain, John Charles Davis.
I avail myself of it, and if I can't, could you tell me how I could? would I be able to...
Yes.
Do you stay in one location when you... give your services? I mean, like an office, or do you move around?
Yes.
You do move around, or you stay in the office? Excuse me, I was giving you two questions there. You stay in one place?
Well, actually, you've got a yes there, and I'd stick with the yes if I were you, Johnny.
Do you wear any particular garb other than normally what you're wearing tonight?
Yes.
You do? Would this be considered a uniform of some kind?
No.
What was the question? I missed it.
A uniform. Would it be some kind of a uniform?
Well, now, let me have a small conversation.
Oh, I knew this was coming.
Sure.
did you understand her say she moved around?
Johnny, I think we have to give you a no. That actually, in ordinary street clothes, such as Miss Proxy is wearing now, could not be worn, but it is not a uniform which would identify in any degree the occupation. Miss Francis?
If one were to avail oneself of your services, Miss Proxer, would you come to the house to be able to take care of those services?
No.
That's $2.08 to go, Mr. Sir.
Miss Proxer, before we go into this, you are studying. May I ask where you are doing your studies?
At North Hagerstown High School.
High school?
Yes.
That's even young for Mr. Daly. Miss Proxer...
I should like to point out that it was not Mr. Daly who was asking the leading questions.
Miss Proxer, this uniform, which is not really a uniform that you wear, is that worn for some protective purpose, or to keep you clean, or to keep you from getting messed up?
No.
No. It's $3.07 to go, Miss
Kilgallen. But it's still not recognizable.
No, actually, it's a matter of convenience, Bennett. It has no purpose to protect her against damage or harm of any kind, nor necessarily any purpose to maintain a state of cleanliness, of which I'm sure you would approve in any and all circumstances. It's just it's good garb for what has to be done.
Thank you, John.
That's perfectly all right. You know, no hair, but lots of brains. That's Bennett, sir, all the time. Miss Kilgallen.
Well, I've got to stick with this uniform or costume a little bit more. Do you wear anything in the nature of slacks or pants of any kind?
Yes.
Oh. I also would like to straighten out Johnny's question, that double question. I didn't understand whether she said yes to moving around a lot or staying in one place.
Well, I think that we could best clarify this issue by saying that while you perform your service in one location, it could also be said that there is some degree of movement involved in the normal offering of the service.
Is your work physical as well as mental?
Yes.
Would you say it was more physical than mental?
Yes.
Are there men doing what you do?
Yes.
Do you ever get up on a ladder?
No.
That's 4 down and 6 to go, Mr. Carson.
Do you talk at all to the people?
Yes.
You do? Do you lay your hands upon them?
Sometimes.
Was you going to say something, John? Or,
I was pondering whether I should add a word so that you weren't misled. The laying on of hands could be necessary as a part of demonstration, you know. In other words, it would have as its purpose to helpfully instruct.
I see. Do the people who come to you wear anything other than...